Put your hands together for the next poet. Give it up for Bosea. Give it up for Bo.
What's up, internet? I'll be honest, y'all. Don't listen to the specificity of my words, but more the wholeness of the energy. This poem is called Boys Will Be Boys.
Everywhere I go, there are men still hung up on their cocks, still driving like dominance is a cure-all, still working like proving you're better is the only way forward, still fighting like winning erases loss. What old-timey king from long ago taught so many little lords that castles were made for spoils? What ancient prince who knew women as only property led tribes into society? What civilization began the trend that the emperor's gender is the gender of all leaders? What early man, bursting with jewels, handed down the doctrine that hierarchy's peak is to rule over all? What history has been erased in order to preserve the history of bellies full on greed? In another age, saber-toothed tiger encounters were always lethal. Leading the hunt was a question of survival. The enemy killed, afraid of death returning in the night when darkness was full of dangerous mystery. There was a time when the spear was solution for what we yet learned to communicate. A gun was more useful before our words taught the higher value of a man alive. The fear which demands control carried more weight when dogs were more wolf, when scarcity wasn't man-made, when the sky was the realm of an angry god shaped like a man. So tell me, why are skyscrapers still so defiant of science? Why is governance still rooted in territory and threat? Why do boys still call other boys gay until their eyes no longer reflect the moon? There's a security blanket no longer needed. Progress proving the poor choice of hoarding toys, of breaking toys as a way to get mommy to listen, of making that which breathes into toys for show and tell, of coveting toys only to lock them in chests, of using toys to tune out what the adults are fighting over. It's been millennia plus plus since the little boy was taught his equal. A little girl is more than a politician's humanizing story. Your little girl fights for her dream and the right to have it. The little girl only benefits the past if she stays that way. Deep down, little girls are just like little boys. Little boys were given thrones long after their expiration date. Little boys built the world in their image. Little boys too often learn a language that covers up the root of their role. Women give birth to them. Family is stronger in the feminine for the sake of all. Humans are symbolic. Relativity is calling us to put down our spears. A bowl longs to feed all from its giving shape, a nourishment that raises warriors that never fight to the death. Now is the time to change the operating system. It is within the feminine that you'll find the code.
Bosea, 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 Bosea. The amazing thing about Bosea is that he is just courageous and unafraid to break rules. I mean, you are getting some of the most masterful spoken word artists on the national and international scene that have donated their time to this important cause. I cannot add to the list of awards that all of these poets have won. Bosea is a Tony Award winner for his work in HBO Deaf Poetry on the Broadway stage. He's an author, He's an actor. He's got an upcoming cameo in a Meryl Streep flick coming out. He's just an amazing cat. I am super excited to get Bosea in here and actually talk to him, because Bosea and I have actually shared some time on the road on tours as well, and he's been a friend of mine. And like I said, for him to be here donating to Say Word is amazing. I hope that you will donate too. Let's check.